According to information from the East African Crude Oil Pipeline, at least 2,502 project-affected persons have been compensated in Uganda, representing 69%, while 8,754 project-affected persons, equivalent to 92%, have been compensated in Tanzania. However, a group of project-affected persons have come out to refute government compensation figures, saying that most people are yet to receive a penny, yet others still have disputes of undervaluation.
Service providers are not giving community members all the money they should receive. This absence of justice at the hands of one of the world's largest corporations is utterly unacceptable.
We demand proper compensation for the people who lost crops and land in preparation for ECOP and Tilenga projects. We demand fairness for the people whose freedoms of speech, movement and association have been curtailed for condemning the projects.
Reverend Fred Musimenta of Chikube District is among the aggrieved affected persons who are yet to receive compensation. He is concerned that the East African Crude Oil Pipeline has started transferring their land titles into the company names before they are adequately compensated.
Reverend Fred Musimenta from Chikube District is not yet compensated. And what worries us so much is that ECOP and the new plan are going on processing land titles for the pipeline without compensating us. We are worried.
Clergymen and a Green Faith organization that brings together leaders from Islam and diverse Christian denominations in Uganda have today addressed the press in Kampala and expressed displeasure with the way oil projects at Kingfisher and Tilenga oil fields are proceeding in total disregard of the public outcry.
The sensitization of people, how to use these funds, how much, for example, compensation rates have not been given to these people as they ought to have been given, such that information is given to these people, which is key to their forming decision, has not been done as to how it would have been done.
Different land compensation rates were issued for different districts, no matter the tenure systems. This is not a new story. Uganda's leaders should have known better. We know the effects of oil drilling on the people of Niger Delta, South Sudan, Angola, and Sudan.
Reverend Barold Matovu from Sembabule urged the government to listen to the grievances of the project-affected persons and address them.
Yes, we are saying that government should listen to the voices of the people. There are those who cannot speak, but if we are speaking for them, let the government listen.
The 1,443 kilometer crude oil export pipeline will transport Uganda's crude oil from Hoima in Uganda to the Tanga port in Tanzania, and a total of 13,158 persons have been affected. Only 11,140, an equivalent to 85%, have been compensated. Green Faith is concerned that matters of the environment have remained at the sidelines of the project.
Water from the central processing facility in Tilenga has caused flooding and destroyed the crops and structures in its way. No one has listened to the cries of the people on this sensitive matter despite the risks.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.